Hello, race fans. Welcome to race 22 of the Miller Lite NASCAR Cup Series season. I am joined today by Bob Jakowski and Jones Boy. Are you guys excited for this race?
Yes.
I am very excited for this race. This is my this is one of the closest tracks to me, so I'm very excited to see this race unfold.
All right, let's go trackside for the command.
Drivers, start your engines.
Cars are beginning to roll off now. It's a beautiful day here at Pocono Raceway. These cars are ready to rumble. We're gonna go take a look at your starting lineup. On pole is Caleb Marinelli with a 53.255. Jared Holm listed as outside. Row 3 features 2 feature Tanner Campos and Colin Dover. Brandon Allen makes up row 3 to Dylan Jones down the outside. Bacon Thief, JDF and Bregler, Nick Nelson, and Justin Ritchie are the top 10. Let's take a look at your Miller Lite NASCAR Cup Series keys to the race.
Now, the first one is you got to be aggressive on the restarts, because you can make up lots and lots of position on the restarts here at Pocono if you can just power to the front, get by people, and restarts are key here today.
The second thing to have a key on is protecting the bottom. The bottom is pretty much the best line through all the corners. That's one thing that we need to watch out for, because we know these drivers, for some reason, when they have the lead, do not like the bottom, so we're definitely going to have to keep an eye on that.
And with these long straightaways, high drag and horsepower package, that means that there's a lot of draft gear. It's going to be very hard to break away from anyone, and it's going to be very easy to pull back up to the leader after he's passed you. Here we come, out of turn 3, pace car pulls off. Marinelli, Holmes, Campos, Colin Dover lead them back to the line. Green flag in the air. We're underway at Pocono. Surprisingly,
Marinelli leading them down into turns 1, and he's just leading them down. Tanner Campos gets by Jared on the... No, he does not.
Surprisingly,
Kyle Marinelli with an amazing start.
That was surprisingly tame. I expected a lot more guys to try to go 3 wide than that, but they all stayed relatively calm. That gives Kyle Marinelli an easy race lead. Tanner Campos trying to get to third or second. He's already in third. Brandon Allen now trying to get around Colin Dover for fourth.
Man, look at Colin Dover. Last time he was up front, he completely held up the front, and now he's actually able to compete somehow. That's a pretty good change of equipment right there.
Yeah, that team has definitely upped their commitment, their equipment level. You see Bacon Thief there in the 78 trying to get around this 27 now.
So the 96 finally got to the bottom, as we said early on in the broadcast that it's key to hold the bottom and to be on the bottom. So I'm pretty sure the 96 of Jared Holmes is very happy to find his way to get to the bottom line.
Someone who's not on the bottom line yet, here's Dylan Jones. He's going to fall back behind the five of JDF and Bregler.
Dylan Jones now finally dropping to the inside line.
Looks like he might be able to get the bottom line here. And it looks like he's still kind of trying to run a bit of a middle line for some reason. Even though we said it's better to run the bottom. But it looks like he's still trying to run the middle.
Yeah, turn three is a little bit of an oddity with that grip strip right in the middle. That's actually the preferred line right there. Although you see guys able to make passes on the bottom in turn three. As you see here, Bacon Thief now trying to get around the 96 for fourth.
It looks like Jared Holmes got pushed up a bit to the high line.
It seems that JDF and Bregler were trying to crawl up to Colin Dover to get to the main front here, but not working out as Brandon Allen dives down on the inside of Tanner Campos heading into turn two, and he completes the pass, heading up to try and take on his new teammate, Caleb Marinelli.
Look at Race Gaze running 1-2. That team has been going through a revival since Marinelli jumped ship. Before, they were just kind of faded around 11th to 15th place cars. Now they're running 1-2.
Yeah, ever since Marinelli joined in the team, I talked to Brandon the other day. They have got their... Oh, he dives it down real close under Marinelli and takes the lead away from Caleb Marinelli going in. Oh, but Marinelli's putting up a fight as they go out of turn one.
Yeah. Side by side for the lead. It's Caleb Marinelli and Brandon Allen, teammates.
Does Allen fight him here? Does he die? Dives it in deep!
Fights him! Oh my god, okay.
This is a close battle between teammates for the lead. But here comes Bacon Thief trying to get into it.
Bacon Thief now shoots it down underneath. Oh my god!
Here comes Tanner Campos now looking for third. But he's got no help now. With no draft, he's going to fall quite a ways back. Unless Jared's going to help him, which it doesn't look like it because it's Jared.
Nope, it seems that JDF and Bregler's going to try and help him there. So that's good. But now Colin Dover and Jared Holmes are now stuck, mitigated to the outside line. They're probably going to end up falling back a little bit before they get onto the straight stretch here.
Here comes
Caramel. He's going to try and get the position back from Bacon Thief. As they're going to go side by side, entering the corner.
Here comes Caleb, looking for second. Looks like he's got position. He should be able to get it heading into turn three. When you see the five there of JDF and Bregler, he's gotten around Jared Holmes. Now he's looking around Colin Dover to get into the fifth position.
Oh, man, he is really making a charge towards the front here. Seems that he's got one of the fastest cars on the track right now.
Both of his teammates went down to try to pick him up. Let's see what happens. Jared actually went down to go three wide.
Oh, damn. All of them are Fords.
Holy crap.
Oh, and they go ahead and go back to two wide. Probably a smart idea. Probably not the best idea to go three wide on the straight here. As JD might look to the inside. No, he doesn't.
No, he goes outside, and that gives Jared a chance to get underneath him again.
And we have Tanner Campos trying to battle with Bacon Thief.
Yeah, Tanner's been jumping up the standings recently, up to third in points. What a run it would be if he could somehow get to the regular season championship.
Yeah, Tanner's been really consistent suddenly, just had sudden speed these last couple of weeks, and he is just charging to the front here. Maybe, just maybe, he could lock in and get his first win here at Pocono.
That'd be very... very insane to watch, because he's been so close to getting his first win this season so many times, and he's been very disappointed that he still hasn't gotten that win yet. Today might be his day.
He's definitely very frustrated, especially since he has 2 second place finishes to the same driver. Definitely not a lot of guys that would be very happy about that.
Yeah, I'm sure that he's not exactly too excited about those finishes. But as you can see here, Justin Newman back in the pack, along with Kyler Scott, Nick Nelson, Seabass, Blode, Ryan Gregory, if I'm correct back there, among others, coming out of Turn 3.
That's an absolute hornet's nest back around 11th to 20th. Look at all those cars in one spot.
It's like a snake going in and out and in and out of lanes constantly back there.
And look at Kyler.
I wouldn't be surprised if they keep doing that and it causes a wreck.
Look at Kyler Scott in the middle of that. He does not need to be there. He is one of the drivers in that battle for the regular season championship. He needs to get up front now, but he can't get to the bottom.
Along with that, you can see Carter Jones back there, along with Gavin Grant. They really need to start making the charge towards the front here, or they could try and play it safe. It's really depending on if they play it safe or not here, because safe could either get them caught up in a crash or avoid it. It's really 50-50 chance here, but it seems that they're playing it safe and not trying to make a run for the lead.
Speaking of charge to the front, JD has just taken the fourth position from Bacon Thief, so now Ford 1-2-3-4 in this race.
And he has got a fast, wicked Jonesfeld hot rod today here at Pocono. Oh my goodness, I wouldn't be surprised if I saw him charge past three people in front of him.
It looks like they're staying single file a bit for now, so not too much action towards the front.
Pocono tends to do that, and not a real lot of opportunity to sort of pack race here. But still very close racing. As you see Tanner...
And there comes Tanner Campos underneath the 15 of Caleb Marinelli, former teammates.
Tanner is going to try to get around the 15. Definitely...
They're still side by side.
Definitely about equal car. JD is going to go with his teammate right here. Let's see what happens.
Oh, and they fall back into that long line there. Oh, but
JD
pulls himself back out.
JD's going to try and battle him. He's going to take the position. JD, effing Bregler to third place.
Tanner held off Bacon Thief there, who got stuck. Now Bacon Thief's going to try to hold off the 27 of Colin Dover. Now, Bregler to the inside of Marinelli for second.
Oh, he's making a charge to the front now. Oh, my goodness gracious. He is putting up one hell of a fight for to get past Marinelli and to keep Tanner and everyone else behind him. Oh, and he dives down, and he doesn't complete it coming through turn three.
He can't quite get there.
Oh, he completes it. Second to J.D. Bregler.
Holy crap, I don't know how he did that. Just shoved his way up the track.
I don't think J.D. Effenbregler's done yet. I think J.D. Effenbregler is going for the effing lead now. He's just got to wait for the perfect opening, but here comes Tanner Campos back underneath Caleb Marinelli, taking away third from him.
Oh, not yet. Marinelli fighting back.
They're still side by side.
I don't know why Bacon Thief's trying to go to the outside. He's going to get stuck here heading into the tunnel turn.
Oh, that's going to easily screw him over in the tunnel turn here as he surprisingly keeps... Oh, no, he's starting to fall back a little bit in the tunnel turn. That was definitely not the right move to do there. As Colin Dover goes by Dylan Jones and now dives it down inside of Bacon Thief.
Dylan Jones making a nice recovery after falling back early. Bregler is right up to the bumper of Brandon Allen for the race lead.
Yeah, as you can see there, the time in between those two. Oh, and he dives it down. Let's see if he can get... he gets underneath him. Can he complete
battle,
the pass?
Going battle for the lead. I think he's got it. I think he's got it. Not yet. Not yet.
Allen putting up a fight.
Who does Marinelli go with? You would think
teammate or Bregler?
Teammate
either
or
his teammate. Or go with his former teammate here, and it seems he's going to go down to the inside.
It doesn't... still side by side heading into turn three. Dead even. Allen with the advantage. Marinelli.
And Marinelli going with Allen. Can Bregler hold him? Oh, he does, going on to the front stretch. Bregler takes the lead and leads the first lap. This lap at Pocono. What the hell am I talking about?
I don't know why
Evan Bregler takes the effing lead here at Pocono.
Here comes
Marinelli
Justin
diving it down.
Here comes Justin Ritchie now up into the top 10. Richie's a car you got to pay attention to. Loves Pocono, is one of its home tracks, and he's got a hot rod here today.
Oh, yes, he does. He's been fast all weekend, not as fast as the top three. It's Owen Allen diving it down below Marinelli again. Can he get by him?
Brandon Allen has been aggressive. He's not taking any crap from anyone.
Brandon Allen has been very aggressive lately.
He's been getting really frustrated in these series. And I think now is the time where he's like, he's had enough. He's ready to battle as hard as he can to get the... to get the one he so much desires.
Oh, yeah.
He definitely seems that way.
Yeah, Brandon Allen, very frustrated with his inconsistency, wants to get off on a better foot. Obviously, he just wants some consistency, but I think he wouldn't complain too much about a win right here.
Oh, I'm sure he wouldn't. I'm sure that he would love to get a win. That would definitely rocket him up a little bit higher in points and, you know, just give him a little bit more of a cushion going into the playoffs, so if he fucks up and is inconsistent again, he can be inconsistent and not have to worry about it that much.
Oh, speaking of not fucking up, I think he's going for the lead. But we're focusing on Tanner
instead.
He might
be, but I can't
tell. Here he is. Here he comes. He's going
to
take it.
Pulls back into the lead, going on to the front stretch here at Pocono. Owen Marinelli dives down below Bregler.
Yeah, but no help. I don't think he can stay there. No, he can't. Colin Dover now to the inside of Bacon Thief for fourth.
Coming on to the straight stretch here, as you can see, we're going to go back towards... Oh, now never mind, apparently. Bacon Thief trying to get back around Colin Dover.
And he does,
but he is on that little bit higher of a line. No, he does clear him. As J.D. Bregler is itching. I can tell he wants to get back around to the front. I know he wants to get back to the front because in his mind, that's where he belongs. I'm sure that's what he's thinking.
Allen to the bottom of the track. I think he's coming in this time by. Here he comes.
Indeed, he does go to the pits.
He's brought along with him Colin Dover and others.
So now, green flag pit stops will begin.
JD is going to lead that lap with Marinelli in second. Bacon Thief now third. Barn Pool now is up to fourth. That's the highest a Chevrolet's run so far. Actually, no, wait, never mind. That's a Chevrolet in front of him.
Yeah, that wasn't a Ford there.
Jared.
But you know what? It's all right. A lot of cars dove down pit road, so.
It doesn't really matter. It's a pit sequence.
Yeah.
Here comes JD. He's indicating he's coming this time by, as is Caleb, Bacon Thief, I think Bar and Pool, the rest of that group are coming in, too. There's only
one car staying out.
Seabass.
Of Seabass?
I don't know why he's staying out. I don't think it's too much of an advantage. The tire wear, I don't think it's a good idea to actually stay out in this circumstance, but he does to lead the lap.
He's possibly trying to work a strategy here where if he stays out, maybe there'll be a caution and that might help him, but I don't think that'll help him too much since pretty much everyone's pitted right now. That won't really do him too much, I don't think.
If a caution came out, strategy wouldn't work, he would have to pit anyway, so we'd go to the rear of the field.
JD's gonna win this race off pit road with this sequence. We're gonna have to see where Brandon Allen comes out. There's Allen right there. Oh, he's gonna blast by him on the outside right here.
And indeed, as you predicted, Allen did just blast by J.D. Bregler and Caleb Marinelli, but you know they're going to have quite the intense race going all over the track now.
Oh yeah. There's Carter Jones and Kyler Scott, two of the cars in the in that tight points battle. Jared Holmes with a horrible stop, falling way outside the top 10.
Yeah, he's been having some really bad pit stops lately, especially after Watkins Glen. He had a horrendous one there, and now he had a really bad one and fell back even more. Maybe he really needs to look into getting some, maybe just train his pit crew a little bit more, because they are very slow, it seems.
Yeah, not a lot of luck with that pit crew. As you see here, Seabass is just now coming out, so he's going to blend in, I think, around the 12th position. Yeah, there he is right there. As you see here, Colin Dover and Nick Nelson are racing each other. Baron Poole and Greg Servia right behind him.
Greg Servia, I haven't talked about him much today, but there he was. Along with Jesse King, he qualified. That's amazing. Okay, anyways.
Brian Leon with a terrible day.
Yeah.
That's a majorly unfortunate. Here's Seabass racing around with KR, Kyler Scott, and Tanner Campos, who also had a really bad stop. He's running top five. Now he's around 15th.
Yeah, it seems so far that all the Hosemad pit crews are really struggling today. I don't know if it's a moral thing or something, but they are really not doing well today.
I'm afraid for this pit crew because you already know Jared's going to be on their ass after this race.
They might get stabbed. That's probably going to happen, let's be honest. But
yep.
Anyways.
I think worse.
Stabbed, dismembered, beheaded. Probably one of those.
But
anyways.
Something.
Yeah, always something. It's Jared. You know something's going to go down.
You know something's going to burn.
Brandon out.
Yeah.
Brandon Allen here with a pretty big lead. This is his first race with Blue Moon on the car. It would be real nice if he could get them a win.
Oh, man, let me tell you something. I got talking to him the other day, and apparently they had issues getting their Blue Moon car to get, you know, working and functioning, and like they were trying to decide on the design on the car along with other things. They were originally going to run it at Old Spice, and then even if they were to run it, they went out on like lap four or something, and now they finally get to run it, and look at him in the lead. He's been there for quite a long time. I'm sure that sponsor's going to stick around probably the next season and probably past that.
We shall see, but he better watch out. The 5 and the 15 are catching him quick. Gained 4/10 that last lap.
Oh, shit. You know this is going to be an interesting thing to watch because Allen's been really, really aggressive. Bregler is always aggressive because he wants mass hysteria. And Marinelli, well, he's Marinelli. He'll probably be there. But still, anyways, you know, it's going to be interesting to see these three go up against each other.
And it looks like the lead is pretty much filled, like the top three is pretty much filled with Fords. One from Hosemad and the other's from, I forgot the team name because my memory is a jerk.
Race Gaze is the name of it.
Thank you. My brain, I think I need to get surgery for it.
Oh no.
That'd be bad, but I think before the camera started to pan, yep, Marinelli was diving it down underneath J.D. Bregler going through the tunnel turn, and he doesn't quite clear it.
Is now a bad time for a Matt Tiff joke?
Probably. But you know what? Go ahead.
I'm not going to do it. Marinelli takes second. You see that second pack right there? They're closing in pretty quick. You see, last time by, Nelson was 2 seconds back. This time, he's only about a second and a half.
Oh, yeah, he is really catching that entire group there with all the draft they have. By the way, Bregler passed Marinelli, but still, that entire group that they have just freight training to get up towards the front three, and then that'll really spice things up whenever we have people like Nick Nelson, Servia, Poole, Bacon Thief, and Carter Jones is in that pack as well, so that'll definitely be good for him and his points.
Carter Jones has been beating his chest all week saying, watch out for Pocono, watch out for what we got at Pocono. It's coming to 10 laps to go. If he's got something for these leaders, he's got to show it.
Yeah, because so far he's just shown that he runs well in the pack and all that stuff, but he hasn't really shown that he's got race-winning speed this weekend, so let's hope for him that he can work his way up there and finally reveal that he's got that race-winning speed over there with that Hosemad equipment.
JD has been actually stuck behind Brandon Allen here. I'm kind of shocked about that. We saw it before. He was able to get underneath him pretty easily. Now Brandon Allen's able to hold him off.
Yeah,
looks
I was
like
thinking the same thing. Maybe he's just waiting and conserving, but I doubt he'd do that. It's J.D. Bregler, so maybe Allen is just holding him off really well. I don't know. So it could be either, honestly.
Yeah, I don't think J.D. has the patience to wait to pass him. I think he wants to pass him now and get away as fast as he can, but it just looks like he can't find an opening where he can pass Brendan Allen, but... Hey, who
if
knows?
You look there at the time, he actually lost a little bit that lap going down the front stretch. So it seems that Allen is ever so slightly pulling away from Bregler.
Oh, you saw Bregler jump a little bit up the track there. Not enough for Marinelli to actually get underneath him. He might be trying another line right here, trying to get around him. You see, he does it again just a little.
Yeah, he must be trying to see if that will give him an advantage going through the corner so he could get by Allen, but so far it seems very unsuccessful.
It looks like they're just still going to stay single file. Oh. They're still trying to find someone.
I thought he was trying to dive it down there for a moment, but he was not. And if you look here, let's see, he gained just a little bit, and that pack is catching at an alarming rate. We're going to have a lot more people to talk about here in a moment than other than these three here soon.
Greg Servia has gained about 3/10 in the last two laps. Bregler right to the back bumper. Is he going to try something?
Oh, let's see if he tries something in the corner. He does not try something in the corner. That is odd. I thought he would have, or maybe even spun out Allen for the lead. I wouldn't be surprised.
Like the devil himself.
I do want to bring up Greg Servia.
That's pretty lame.
He's not very like in the garage.
Beat up
a lot of people, week in and week out, really do think that he's probably going to be the worst driver out on the track during the week.
It seems that Poole went by him, actually.
Baron Poole has taken over the fourth position now, and let's see, he lost a little bit of time there. Greg Servia with the crossover.
Man,
I think Poole knew
I
was talking about him.
At the same time as I would love to see this great, back and forth racing, all that's going to do is allow the leaders to pull away with their draft. They should all work together to get up to the leaders, then battle. Then it would make it very intense again, and give everyone a lot better of a shot at winning this race.
Yeah, but really,
and make it a lot more entertaining.
I think really the only person from this lead pack that's going to have a shot is the person that's leading it. So that's what you're seeing with Greg Servia and Baron Poole. They want to be the first one to catch this group.
Yeah, it seems, because Jones is just sticking behind Nelson, also because he's on the outside of Bacon Thief, so... Well, inside, actually, but you understand what I'm saying here.
No,
he
was on the outside waiting. I get it.
And then we have the other group slowly starting to catch this group.
Indeed. Wow. Allen doing an amazing job of holding off J.D. Bregler, but I know that I say that it's probably going to end up swapping leads here soon, which would be a bad thing with the amount of laps we have left here.
Allen jumped out to a pretty big lead. Let's see, Marinelli's to the inside for the second position. When these leaders go side by side, that's enabling Greg Servia and Baron Poole to catch a much bigger wake.
And it looks like race days are going to have the top two here if Caleb Marinelli can clear JDF and Bregler.
Ooh, he's going to slide up. He does.
And clear Bregler. Race Gay is now running 1-2 as
crossover
sends it down on the inside without any help. Let's see if he can make this work going into turn
no
one.
No draft, clean air. He is going to dive it down into turn one to try to take the second spot away. He does. But that just...
Servia and Poole have caught up.
There,
now it has gone from a 3 to a 5 car battle.
They are there.
This is going to get intense, folks.
Watching from the back, from the rear camera of Brandon Allen, watching that 5 car J.D. Bregler diving in.
Man, it seems that they're more or less even going through the turns and mostly on the straightaway. Let's see if he can catch up a little bit here.
Oh, no, Allen.
It seems that Allen pulls away a little bit at the beginning of the turn and turn exit. They seem to be even, so then... He's going to need help from someone to catch up to Allen now, because there's not many laps to go.
But when you see that draft start to reel Brandon Allen back in for Bregler, you see Bregler go wide again, trying to gain some momentum.
Not get there.
That would've...
I wouldn't be surprised as these laps start to wind down that he might see a bumper to the back of the 24 moment, but instead of the 24, it's going to be the 07.
Servia to third.
Oh, man.
At least attempting. He's to the inside of Marinelli.
Servia trying, but Poole staying with Marinelli.
I am shocked by that one. I don't know why Poole wouldn't... I don't know why Poole wouldn't go with Servia or even try to make it three wide.
Yeah, that surprises me a lot more. Yeah, that... And they seem to be still side by side.
Bregler and Allen are pulling away. Three to go.
Oh, you see Carter Jones back there trying to make a move to get towards the front with two to go. He's going to have to get some intense speed to get up there.
Greg Servia to third.
He's going to try and find his way up to those leaders.
JD is right to the back bumper. Trying to make Brandon Allen shit himself as they enter the tunnel turn.
No, he cannot dive it in. But I'm sure the pressure is really being put on that 07 car from having the 5 behind him for so goddamn long.
Bregler, I think, is trying to make Brandon Allen shit himself.
I think that, yeah, that's kind of easy to do. Kind of.
Will we see a code brown? Will we see a code brown in Brandon Allen's car?
Two to go.
I really hope not. That would not exactly be a good thing to see. Oh, and Servia
dive bombs.
Servia to second.
Whoa, not so fast. Bregler with the run on the outside. Coming down.
Side by side for second.
Coming down the long straightaway on the backstretch. Bregler got back around the 22.
Now it's back to Bregler and Allen. Let's see if Bregler can make a move, or will Allen fuck up like he always does? Let's see. Time to find out.
They're coming to the white flag. If Bregler was holding anything back, it's go time. Carter Jones up to fifth.
Man, Carter's been so hyped for Pocono. I doubt it, but if he is able to pull something out of his ass, that'd be amazing, and he'd at least live up to what he was saying. But Bregler trying to get around Allen and failing miserably. But let's see if he can do something on the straight stretch going into the tunnel turn.
Let's see right here. He's right to the back bumper. Does Allen take a defensive line? He does not. Bregler does not try to dive it in. He goes wide.
Oh.
He's probably waiting for the final corner.
Allen, up the track. Here comes Servia.
Servia down to the inside.
That's
he's going to ruin Shady chances to win this race.
And that seals it. Out of turn three.
Turn three. That makes it.
Brandon Allen wins at Pocono.
Wins at Pocono. Sweet. Oh, that is great. I know that guy. And I'm sure he's probably happy about that. I can assure you.
That was pretty nice.
That was pretty good. I mean, although we didn't have any cautions, I gotta say, that was really good racing. Back and forth, constantly being swapped for the lead and all that stuff. A lot of jumbled up cars through the field and all that stuff. Man, that was pretty good. That was really good, actually.
Yeah, that was pretty solid.
That's probably the best race at Pocono I've seen in a long time.
That was amazing. Man, Brandon Allen had an amazingly fast car. I mean, he didn't even qualify that well. I think, what was it, fourth?
He qualified fifth. Wound up leading 24 of the 32 laps.
And now he's here to do some donut.
Let's see if he can actually manage a sweet burnout. Man, I'm sure that sponsor's real happy about having him on that car.
Ooh.
Sweet, he's gonna hit the...
Not that much. No one's gonna notice.
No. Yeah.
Plus, it's going in victory. Plus, it's in victory lane, and it's Pocono. Who gives a crap? It does. The car doesn't translate anywhere.
Exactly. Oh man. Man, look at him doing them sweet donuts. I mean, they could be a little bit better, but you know what? Hey, he's still getting used to, you know, winning things like that. But man, I gotta say, ever since Marinelli joined the team, the morale for that team has gone through the roof. He's got his second win. Marinelli got 2 wins in 3 weeks. Sydney Allen's been running well. Ocean Isherwood's been running great. Chase Hemingsgard, we don't mention him, but that's besides the point. Ignoring him, everyone else has been great. So that's pretty good.
Chase Hemingsgard
just... makes you wonder what was going through Jarrett's mind with firing Caleb Marinelli, because he seriously turned this team around.
He probably
regrets it.
Maybe Jose Mad just wasn't right for Caleb, because that's a race-winning team in its own right. But now he comes to race gaze, he's the leader on that team. Brandon Allen takes the checkered flag.
And takes the checkered, and there you go. A little bit of a wheel spin, but you know what? Doesn't matter. Who cares?
First,
he just won a race. I'm sure he is excited. He probably did shit himself, let's be honest, because last win was at a super speedway, and this is quite different. It's a triangle.
Brandon Allen going to pull into victory lane. Second career win, second of the season. I'd like to thank Bob Jakowski and Jones Boy. Here are your results. These trials make us who we are.